If you're building in Softr, your day just got better because they have recently released workflows. This allows us to take automated action steps directly from our Softr applications. I'm going to walk you through this new feature step by step. So if that's of interest, stick around and let's get into it. Welcome back to the channel. If you're new here, my name is Gareth, and this is Gap Consulting. It's our mission here to help you unlock the full potential of no-code tools, and Softr is one of those tools that we use all the time with our clients. Now, in this video, as I said, we're going to be taking a look at their brand new feature for workflows. We can now take automated action steps within Softr itself. I'm going to be breaking it down for you, but before we get into it, I first want to invite you to follow along with me in your own Softr account. If you don't already have Softr, you can sign up using our referral, which I am including here on my screen. If you follow the steps that you see on your screen now, you can get one free month on their Pro plan, which is over $100 US in savings. So it's actually a pretty generous referral link. I would definitely suggest signing up if you are new to this. But without further ado, let's go ahead and hop on into my screen, and I'm going to show you where to find the new workflows. We're going to talk about all of it, including what they currently offer, and also what it means for your pricing with Softr. So first and foremost, you're gonna find the workflows here from your Softr dashboard. So I am not logged into a specific application. I am on the dashboard. That's an important takeaway because when I first started, I dove into a specific portal of mine and I was trying to add the workflow and it does not live there. It is at the top level right now. So you can go into the workflows and you can start from scratch or with a template and start building your first workflow. So you can decide what the trigger is, right? You have Softr AI triggers not yet available for triggers, but there are Softr AI components available for action steps. We can also look at our Softr apps and Softr databases. So we can take action based on things happening here. We can also set up webhooks. So, you know, if you have experience building some more advanced automations with webhooks, you're going to love this. We also have a one-time schedule and a recurring schedule. In addition to that, we can take action from the places that we might be storing our data. So I have Airtable, Gmail, and Google Sheets as options also, because these are different data sources that I have already integrated with Softr. So in our use case, we might go with an Airtable or a Softr database. You'll notice that we can do things like triggering off of records being added or records being deleted. Also when records are updated or when records meet conditions. Now you might want to pay good close attention to the time component here because this is how often the polling will occur for these different automation triggers. So if you need your automations to be in real time, definitely be on the lookout for those instant triggers. So for example, we could establish a trigger where records meet very specific conditions and it will trigger instantly. But if we are doing something like when a new record is added, you'll notice that it is on a 15-minute timer. So we can go ahead and make the selection here and pick whatever database. These are Softr databases, of course. But as I demonstrated, you can also integrate with other data sources. Let's say we wanted to look to see when a new contact is added. And we can establish some conditions to be the email is not empty, for example. So we'll go ahead and plug that in here. And so just like that, we built ourselves a trigger that says when a contact comes into existence where the email is not empty, and then we can set up our test. We can run a test on the trigger. You can see here that we're finding some information about that. And then it's time to build our action steps. Now, this probably looks very familiar to you if you've been building automation in Zapier or Make or Airtable. The rules are relatively the same. We trigger our automation based on some conditions that we establish. When the automation is then triggered, we then set forth the rules or the things that it's going to do, and those are the action steps. And for being a brand new feature, I've got to say, Softr has really come out of the gates swinging. They have already built in automation potential with Anthropic and OpenAI. We have Postmark, we have Google Calendar, Gmail, Slack, etc. We also have those more advanced features that you would expect from a proper automation tool, like branches, conditional logic within our automation, filters, where we can set up rules that say only do this part of the automation if conditions are met. We can also add pauses or waiting to our automation, and we can take bulk actions, looping within our automations. So pretty good stuff, not to mention some even more robust things like scraping web pages, extracting data from PDFs, and of course, using Softr's AI within the automation itself. So a lot of options available for us here inside of our Softr workflows. But as I promised, we have to talk about plans and pricing. What does it mean for us now that workflows are available? Have prices gone up? Well, I'm happy to report that no, they have not yet gone up. I don't know if there is an intention to raise prices in the future, but for now, these prices on Softr are exactly as they were last month. The free version, the basic version, the professional, and the business version are what they share on their website. These prices that I have showing on my screen right now are based on the monthly payment cycle, not the annual payment cycle, so bear that in mind. If we scroll about halfway down on the pricing page, that's where we see the workflow edition. So what is included? Well, workflows and steps, there is no amount of workflow or steps that we can have within our automations. All of the plans come with unlimited workflows and steps. Where it does matter is the action executions that we can perform on the account. But I think you'll agree that if you're on the professional or business tiers with Softr, there are quite a lot of executions being included with that pricing. So we get $2,500 on the basic plan all the way up to $25,000 per month on the business plan. Next, we're talking about the app UI triggers and actions, and every plan has this. They also have, all plans have AI actions. Now, when it comes to the utilities, those more advanced features or functions within the workflows, branching, bulk actions, filtering, and waiting, which we discussed in the workflows, that is available for the free plans and above. But if you want to do the more advanced things like run code, scraping pages, extracting PDFs, please notice that those particular actions or utilities are only available for the basic or paid plans and above. In terms of the webhook and API, if you're building those more advanced webhook or API automations, you only get those starting at the professional tier. So make sure to bear that in mind. And you also see that polling is improved substantially based on the tier that you are on. So if you are a business user, you don't have to wait the 15-minute timing for that poll. It is a 1-minute timer, which obviously speeds things up significantly. In terms of run history, if you're on that business tier, you get 3 full months worth of run history to review. But if you're on a free plan, you only get 7 days. So bear that in mind when you're picking your preferred Softr plan. And then also in terms of execution time, this is the maximum processing time allowed for a single workflow run before it times out. So if you've built a really complex script, perhaps, that is forcing this automation to think quite hard, well, you only get up to 5 minutes on the free plan. So bear that in mind when you're putting this stuff together. But if you're up to the professional plan, there is no time limit. It is unlimited. So that's it in a nutshell. Big stuff from Softr, automation potential directly in the platform. And for you, this might mean that your reliance on third-party automation, things like Zapier or Make, you can bring those bills down or maybe eliminate them altogether if you start building more automation directly in Softr. I'm excited to try it out myself. I know I've got a lot of different use cases in mind, especially where it comes to users inside of my app that I'm excited to start implementing for my no-code apps. I hope you got a ton of value from this video. As always, if there are questions you have that I didn't quite answer here, swing by our website because we've put a ton of resources there for you to help you implement these things into your businesses. Of course, if you loved the video, a thumbs up would go a long way. Subscribe to the channel, but most importantly, my friends, keep on building.